Hey guys, welcome to linear regression episode. Here you will learn what is linear regression and in-depth math intuition behind it. I have used animation to make it very easy to understand. In the next video, we will see the coding part and we'll also make our own machine learning algorithm which has accuracy 100% equal to scikit-learn's. So let's get started. First of all, what is linear and what is regression? By definition of linear, it means that arranged in or extending along a straight or nearly straight line. In simple words, a straight line in a graph is termed as linear as it shows a linear relationship between the data. Contrary, if any line which is not straight like the sine or cosine curve and any polynomial equation is non-linear. Hence, it shows a non-linear relationship between the data. Coming to the regression part, it allows us to calculate the value of y based on the value of x, where x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable. In clean words, if you take any equation like this, you can simply calculate the value of y if the value of x is given to you. Pretty simple. That's why in linear regression, term linear means a straight line. Now coming to the very main part, which is the equation of linear regression. In high school, we have studied the equation of straight line, which is y is equal to mx plus c. In linear regression, we use the same equation, but instead of c, we use b. It has the same meaning, but in general we always use b in machine learning. So let us more deep dive into the equation part. If you are not interested in the math part, you can directly skip to this timeline. Let's dive. As we saw earlier, the equation y is equal to mx plus b. Also we discussed what is x and y. But wait, then what is m and b? In this equation, m is the slope of line and b is the y-intercept. The slope is how much steep or gentle is your graph. In this example, the slope of the line is 2. We will see how to calculate this a little later, and the y-intercept is a point where our graph intersects with the y-axis, and here it is 1. So how I calculated it? First, let us see how to calculate y-intercept. An easy way to calculate it is to see from where our line is starting, and in this case we can easily see that it is starting from 1. Let us draw some more lines. Oh great, the first line, which is the yellow one, has y-intercept 0 as it is starting from origin, but the second one, which is the gray, has y-intercept 5 as it is starting from point 5. Now just think about this red line and answer what is the y-intercept of this line in the comment section. But this is not the professional way of calculating the y-intercept. The general formula which we use is the y-intercept is equal to y-mean minus slope into x-mean. Substituting the values of our equation in the formula will give us the y-intercept. Pretty simple. Now let us head towards the slope. Slope has a bit harder formula, but don't freak out. I will explain it to you. In the numerator, we are subtracting every x value with x mean and multiplying the result we get with the y value we got by subtracting it by y mean. And all the values we will finally add it to get our numerator. In the denominator, we are just subtracting x mean with the every value of x and squaring our result, and at last we are adding that all single value to get our denominator, and finally we will divide our numerator and denominator to get the slope. It is a bit trickier to visualize the slope formula, so I highly recommend you to see a post by Varsity Tutors on the least square method, link in the description. Now we will take an example of the Celsius and Fahrenheit scale and we will calculate its slope and y-intercept, and the equation we will get at last will be able to calculate any Fahrenheit value. Let's start. The graph of Celsius to Fahrenheit is this. The formula to convert Celsius value to Fahrenheit is degree Fahrenheit equals 1.8 into degrees Celsius plus 32. We will put Celsius value from 1 to 10 in this equation and store the corresponding Fahrenheit value. For example, I have here put Celsius value equals 2 degrees Celsius and I have got 35.6 degree Fahrenheit as the resultant value. Same we have to do with every Celsius value from 1 to 10 and we will get this as a result. But in machine learning, we term the independent variable as x, in this case which is Celsius value, and y is the variable which is to be predicted when x value is given. In this case, it is degree Fahrenheit. Let's change the variable. Now we will calculate x mean and y mean, which can be done by summing all the values and dividing the total number of values, which is 10. We have got x mean equals 5.5 and y mean equals 41.9. We are now all set to calculate slope and y-intercept. Starting with slope, as we saw earlier, slope has a trickier formula, but you can easily do it in your book, but animating it is a little difficult. So I have shown you the value I got by putting values in the slope formula, which is 1.8. This value will help us to calculate y-intercept. Calculating y-intercept by the formula will give us equal to 32.0, which is obviously 32. All the final values are slope equals m equals 1.8 and y-intercept equals b equals 32. Substituting this value in y is equal to mx plus b, which is the general formula of linear regression, ends up giving y is equal to 1.8 into x plus 32. This is our final calculated value. If you compare it with the actual formula, it is exactly the same. This is all about the linear regression. In short, it is taking some x and y values, calculating its slopes and y-intercept, substituting it in y is equal to mx plus b, and you are now all ready to calculate any value of y by just substituting the x value to the equation. This is the end of the first video of the machine learning series. In the next video, we will dive into the coding part and we'll also create our own machine learning algorithm which is able to create the same result as scikit-learn. Until then, you can visit the GitHub repository of this series containing all the code as the video are coming, and I have given you notes which I have written on linear regression which will help you to quickly revise all the stuffs.